This video follows on from the video which gave an overview of how to set up a Totalstation using the setup app. That is, how to position and orientate the Totalstation. This video will describe how to set up a Totalstation using the resection method. The resection method can be used in the following case. The Totalstation is not located over any point of known coordinates. There are at least two backsight points which can be measured too. The position, height and orientation of the Totalstation will then be computed based on the measurements to the backsights. Before completing the setup, it is possible to look at the quality of the measurements to the backsights and exclude any measurements which may be considered wrong or inaccurate. So let's run through the method. As always, move the job we want to use to the centre of the carousel. This means the setup information, for example the instrument height, target points used and so on, will be stored to this job. Now tap on the setup app. Choose the resection method and press OK. And we access the setup details panel. Here we need to enter the ID of the setup. Once we have completed the setup, a point will be stored with this ID and the computed coordinates of the setup. We need to enter the instrument height and, if we wish, a point code. Here we can choose in which job the target points are stored. In my case, they are stored in this job. So now we need to measure to the first target point. We can select it from the list using the point ID or select it from the 3D viewer. We need to enter the height of the target. We aim to the target and then press measure. This will measure to the target and store the measurement. And then we can measure the second target point. We again select the target point, enter the target height, aim to the target, and then press measure. Again, the measurement is made and the measurement is stored. You may notice that the calculate key is now visible. This is because we have now measured two target points and therefore the position, height and orientation of the Totalstation can be computed. We will, however, measure one more target point and we measure to the third target point. And then we could measure the fourth target point. We won't measure a fourth point but instead compute the resection. That is, compute the position, height and orientation of the Totalstation by pressing calculate. Depending on how accurately the target points were measured and or the correctness of the target points themselves, we may get a message informing about the quality of the orientation and or positioning. In the results page tab, we can see the coordinates which have been computed for the Totalstation and the orientation. If it is wanted to apply a height of 0 to the computed station, then untick this checkbox. If we want to measure more target points, we can press Add Target. On the Setup page tab, the instrument height can be seen and re-entered if it had been forgotten or a mistake made earlier. The setup point can be given a point code if needed. The current PPM is shown as a reminder as to what PPM or scale factor is being used. On the Quality page tab, the quality of the setup can be assessed. On the Targets page tab, the individual measurements to the targets can be seen. Here it is possible to change how the individual measurements are used within the computation. For example, maybe there is no height for the first target point. Maybe we only know the easting and northing and we have used a dummy height. Then we can press Use to change the use of this point to only 2D. Or maybe the third point we measured is a heighting benchmark where only the height is known. We can press Use to change the use of this point to only 1D. Or we simply measured wrongly to a target point. We could remove this measurement completely using Remove. If you are using or connected to an imaging Totalstation, then the Camera page tab allows you to capture an image and link it to the station. In the Plot page tab, it is possible to see a 3D view of the setup. This can be useful to visually check the setup and the location of the target points is correct. Once you are happy that all information is entered, then press Set. This will store all setup information to the job. If you are using an imaging Totalstation, you will be asked if you want to capture a panoramic image. And then you will return to the home screen. The instrument is set up and you can get to work. The Settings panel of the Setup app can be accessed using FN and then F1 Settings from within the app. Here you can find some useful settings. In this video, I will only talk about the settings relevant for the resection method. For example, if you want to measure to the target points in two faces, then tick this checkbox. If you do have a prism on any of the targets and don't want them to be found later when using a power search, then tick this checkbox. Another video explains more about this setting. In the Advanced Page tab, there are various settings which can be made. Ticking this checkbox means that once two targets are measured, the instrument will automatically turn to the next point which is selected to be measured. This checkbox allows the setup routine to be exited before it is complete, a so-called on-the-fly setup. This means the surveying of normal topo points can be started before the setup is complete. The setup points can be measured later, and once completed, the whole setup and any measured points will be updated. If this checkbox is ticked, a station scale will be calculated from the target observations. The user will have the option to apply this new scale to all subsequent measurements, including the setup observations from that setup. If not ticked, the calculated scale will not be displayed and not apply to any subsequent measurements. This checkbox means the helmet method will be used to calculate the resection result. Here, the default limits can be changed. If these limits are exceeded, then a message is shown when the location and orientation of the station is computed. When using the setup app on the CS field controller, the F4GS key is extremely useful if you're using a smart pole. That is, you're using a GS sensor mounted on the prism on the pole. This key then allows a point to be measured with the GS sensor, which can then immediately be used to orientate the Totalstation. This is really useful if there are no known targets in the area. You can establish new targets using the GS sensor where it is most useful. So in summary, the resection method is the method to use when you do not know the point over which you will position the Totalstation and you have two or more target points to which you do know the coordinates. Please do watch the other videos to learn more about the individual setup methods. And thanks for watching.